Starting off the tour, we have a standard disconnectable TC. It can be disconnected and reconnected as shown. Here is the upkeep of each external. There are three external TCs on this base. Entering the compound, we have a simple gate airlock. This can be replaced with a gatehouse if you would like. This entrance is covered by two auto turrets, one on either side. Here we have a simple double door, single door airlock. And some nice peaks into each side of the compound. Here you will find one of your three external bedrooms with some Patrico peaks. On two of the three sides, we have a fake door with a battery behind it. Coming round to the real entrance, you have space for some simple deployables such as furnaces or extra batteries. Here you will find your main TC, and here is the upkeep. Coming up into our mini open core, we have space for our level 3 and extra respawn points. You can open the bunkers as shown. Coming up one of the three ladder hatches, we have space for some extra loot room. This can be used for any of your deployables. There are also three respawn points, one on each side. One of these triangle ladder hatches will be your jump up, which goes up to the roof. Here we find some decent peaks into the compound from above, as well as some longer angles using the window frames, as well as the low walls. You can also get some decent angles as shown from above. The roof area is protected by three turrets. And here you'll find some extra roof peaks using these door frames. Starting off the build, you want to place these four triangles as shown to claim your build spot. Seal this in and place your double door frame. Make sure to place this triangle as wood so you can expand later. This starter core is quite small, so I'd recommend having a starter base if you're in larger groups. Now we will do our multi-TC foundations. These will be used for our bunkers later. You want to place 8 squares and come back with half moons. Now you want to demolish the old foundations and place the foundations as shown. Now demolish your build out and come back with 2 squares. Then 1 half moon, another square, and then your final 3 triangle foundations for your TC. Make sure to place 2 half walls here for the disconnectable. Make sure to connect to the foundations as shown. This is what it should look like. Now repeat on all three sides. This is what the base should look like. Now, honeycomb as shown. You want to make sure you place these inner walls backwards as shown to make sure the conditionals cover the gaps. Adding these triangle floors, make sure they attach to the external TCs. Now, simply add garage doors or double doors to cover these fake entrances. Now you can demolish this triangle floor, then continue to expand the base. Now we will add the airlocks and bedroom area. At this stage, you can just simply expand the base on top and complete your bunkers, or you can do the bedrooms as shown. This is what the base should look like. Now we will do the bunkers. Make sure to place these half-height floors before you seal the bunker, otherwise it will not be possible to place them. You want to make sure these triangle floors connect to the inner TC, as shown. Before upgrading the bunker, you can check if it works by placing twig as shown. Now you can simply upgrade. We will now expand upwards to do our extra bedrooms and storage rooms. This is what the base should look like. Now we will do the shooting floor. Now you want to place the triangle foundations as shown. These will be supports for our roof peaks. When placing the compound, you want to place the walls either side of the bedrooms first. This will help with placement. Once you have completed the compound, you can then furnish the base as shown. You may want to upgrade these floors to high quality metal before you place the boxes. This will help with upgrading. When placing these large boxes, you want to code lock them all. Once you have the necessary resources, you can upgrade the shooting floor as shown.